In this video, we are going to see how you can configure view item list event in Google Analytics 4 using Google Tag Manager for your Shopify store. This is a new event that has been introduced into e-commerce tracking. This is very similar to how we used to have impression event in Universal Analytics, but GA4 just makes things a lot more easier because it is more intuitive to build out different reports. Here in the Looker Studio, I have built out a report for the view item list event where we have the item name on the left side and we can see how many of these items has been viewed in a list format on a category page. Shopify by default has a collection page where we can see multiple products on the same page, and this event fires on those pages where we can see how many times a product has received an impression, then how many times the user has clicked it and went to the view item page. This video has been divided into four different sections. In the first section, we are going to configure Google Tag Manager container on our Shopify store so we can track all the events across different pages. In the second section of the video, we will configure Google Analytics Word property on our Google Tag Manager account so we can track basic events such as page view, user engagement, session start, etc. In the third section of the video, we will see how we can configure the scripts that will fire the view item list event on the data layer. And in the fourth section of the video, we will finally configure the tags that will receive this event from the data layer and send it to the Google Analytics 4. Then we can finally do a test and publish everything. There are two prerequisites of this video. You need to have a Google Analytics 4 and a Google Tag Manager container account, and you also need to have a Shopify store for this one. Let's head over to my computer so we can start the tutorial. If you don't have a Google Tag Manager container yet, click on the account and hit create container. We are going to rename this one to trackingacademy.com. And since this is Shopify is a web store, we are going to select web for our property. Once the container has been created, this will automatically redirect you to a page where you can see the head and body snippet for the Google Tag Manager tracking codes. Otherwise, if you can't see it for some reason, then click on this tracking ID on the top right corner and it will open the same page. There is one more place where you can find the same option, that is under the admin section for install Google Tag Manager containers. Let's copy this head code and install it on our website. Let's go back to the Shopify store that we have, and under the Shopify store, let's go to the theme files, and all the theme files by default are located under online stores. If you will click on online store, it will automatically redirect you to the theme section. However, if it does not redirect you, click on the themes. Click on the three dots and duplicate the theme once so you have a copy of your theme file before making any changes. Once you have done that, click edit code on the live theme, and then we are going to select the theme.liquid file. Theme.liquid file is basically a file that adds code on all the pages of the website except the checkout and the final thank you page. So right under the opening tag of the head tag, we are going to paste the Google Tag Manager head code, and let's go back to the Google Tag Manager container to get the body code so we can also paste it on the Shopify store. We are going to search for the body tag on Shopify store, so let's hit next, and this is the opening tag of the body. Let's paste the base snippet and hit format liquid to prettify everything and hit save. What this have done is added the Google Tag Manager code on our Shopify store. Let's just check if everything is working all right. Go back to Google Tag Manager store and workspaces, click on preview. What preview is going to do is attach a debug window to your Shopify store, and now you can see any kind of changes that you make on your Google Tag Manager container in the draft mode, they will be visible. Let's enter the URL of the website. myshopify.com, and once the debug view is connected with your store, you can install this legacy Chrome extension by Google, which will tell you if there is any Google Tag Manager container properly firing on your website or not. Now in the second section of the video, we are going to see how we can configure Google Analytics 4 configuration tags so we can tag page view, session start, and all these other good events by default. Let's head over to our Google Analytics property, and on the bottom left corner, you are going to see an option for admin section. Once you click on the admin, under the property column, let's go to data streams. Data streams are basically pipelines that connect your Shopify store with your Google Analytics accounts or anything basically. There are multiple types of data stream. You can connect Android application, iOS application, and web. Since Shopify is a web store, we are going to create a web data stream if you don't already have one. Since we have already created one, let's just copy the measurement ID for this one. Measurement ID is the unique tracking ID of each data streams, and what analytics account can have more than one data streams. Let's go back to the Google Tag Manager container and let's create a variable for this one so we can reuse this measurement ID again and again. Under the user defined variable, we are going to select a variable which is constant by default. Since the measurement ID is not changing all the time, we don't need to create any kind of custom variable for this one. Let's rename it to GA4 Measurement ID. Let's hit save. Now let's go back to the tag section, and we are going to create one tag that will fire this page view event for all the pages. Since we want this configuration tag to fire on all the pages of our Shopify store, so let's select a trigger that fires event on all pages. For the tag types, if you're using an older version of Google Tag Manager, you might see an option for Google Analytics configuration tag. However, that will soon be replaced by Google Tag. Once you click on Google Tag, it will ask for a tag ID. A tag ID is similar to the one that we just created for GA4. So let's just select that variable where we have the GA4 measurement ID. Let's rename this tag to GTag GA4 configuration tag. By doing this, our configuration tag should be firing on all the pages. So let's just hit preview to make sure everything is working all right. Once you click on preview, it will again connect a debug window to your Shopify store. And if you will click on the assistant window that you have installed on your website, now you can see that there is another GTag firing on the page. And this is for Google Analytics 4. If you go back to the debug window, you can see that we also have a new GA4 container on our debug window, and it has send a page view hit on the configuration event. And this page view hit by default just creates some user IDs, client IDs, and send them to the GA4 account. Perfect. Now in this section 3 of the video, we are going to see how we can configure the scripts for the data layer event in our Shopify store. If you don't have any kind of coding experience, there is a PDF in the description below that you can send to the developer and they can handle everything from there. Otherwise, if you want to code everything yourself, there is also a detailed step-by-step instruction in the blog link in the description below. So let's go back to the Shopify store where we are already on the online team section, and we are going to create two different snippets for this one. Snippets are just piece of code that makes everything organized in Shopify. So let's go to the snippet section, and we are going to create one snippet for head data layer, and we need one more snippet for collection page. So let's create data layer hyphen collection. Since this page is only going to fire on the collection pages, therefore we are renaming it like that. Once you have done that, you're going to copy and paste the script from the description below. Let's paste the snippet for the head file, and now let's copy and paste the snippet for the collection page. Perfect. Once you have done that, hit save on your theme file so these changes has been saved. Let's go back to the theme file where we have the Google Tag Manager body code. For me, the body code is on 256 line, and right under this line you are going to import that snippet. So let's include the head data layer snippet. Awesome. Let's just do a quick walkthrough so you can understand what this code is doing. Right below this Google Tag Manager container, this is including the snippet for the head data layer. And this head data layer is just including a collection page snippet if the user is on the collection page. And this collection page is firing a custom view item list event which have details of the list as the list item name along with the currency parameter. Great. Let's just go back to the Shopify store to any of the catalog pages to see if this collection event is firing properly. Perfect. We went to the home collection page where we have all the products, and we can see that in the Google Tag Manager container, a custom view item list event has fired, which has currency, item list name, and all the details of the three items that are present on the page right now. Seems like the data layer script is working. So now let's head to the fourth section of the video where we are going to create the tracking scripts in Google Tag Manager that will send this event back to the GA4. In our Google Tag Manager account, before creating the tag, we need to create a variable that will extract the values of this items array and item list names. So let's go to the variable section and create the data layer variables that are required for this one. Under the user defined variable, you will see an option for new. So let's click new and let's select the data layer variable. Since these values are being populated inside the data layer, we can use ecommerce.items notation to access anything that's inside an object. So let's do ecommerce.items, and let's rename this tag to DLV or data layer variable ecommerce.items. We can also extract this additional name which comes with item underscore list underscore name, and since this is also inside the ecommerce object, we can use the same notation for ecommerce.item list underscore name. So let's rename this tag to DLV and the same thing. Awesome, everything seems good. In the Google Tag Manager new version, they have also integrated something called Google Tags setting variables, and they are very similar to how we used to have universal analytics variables where you can define everything once and they will be sent back as an event configuration parameter with all the events. So instead of creating these parameters one by one, we can just go to the new event and then select the new data tag. Let's search for Google Tag event settings parameter variable, and we are going to add this items array and item list name. Let's assign the data layer variable that we created for each one of them, and the items array goes here. We also have the currency parameter, so we can go ahead and assign the currency parameter to Perfect. Currency is also inside ecommerce.currency object. So we can create a new data layer variable that will select this currency parameter. ecommerce.currency. Awesome. Let's rename this variable as ecommerce.currency. And let's rename this variable as GTAG event setting GA4 EEC parameter. This just says Google Tag event setting Google Analytics 4 in has ecommerce parameters. Let's hit save. And now we need to create a trigger that will only fire the event on the custom view item list. You might notice that the standard name of the event is view item list. However, we are using custom underscore view item list. The only reason for using this prefix of custom underscore is to avoid any kind of issues that might occur in the future where you might have some other integration of Google Ads or some other plugin. So this integration will not affect that. Let's copy the name of this trigger and go back to the Google Tag Manager and create a new trigger that will fire on this event. Let's select custom event and rename it to custom event custom underscore view item list. Perfect. Now we have everything that we need to create the tag inside Google Tag Manager tag section. So let's go to the tag and create the tag that will finally send this event back to the Google Analytics 4. Click new. And for the trigger, we only want this event to fire on this particular event. So we are going to select that. And under the tag configuration, we are going to select GA4 event tag. For measurement ID, we have already created a constant variable. So let's just refer back to the constant variable. And the name of the event is the standard view item underscore list event. For the event parameter, we can also assign the parameters one by one manually. However, since we have already created the GTAG event setting parameter, we can refer back to the same one. And you can see by default, it will already import all the variables that we have created for that. Everything looks good. So let's rename this tag to GA4 EEC view item list. And let's see. Everything sounds good. So let's just do a test to make sure everything is working all right. And then we can publish the Google Tag Manager container. To test everything, let's hit preview button again, and it will redirect us to the Shopify store where we have connected a debug view. Let's go to the catalog page where this collection event is going to fire. And let's go back to the debug window. On the debug window, we can see that a custom view item list event has fired. And under the GA4 container, we can see that it has sent a request of view item list with all the event parameters such as product 1, product 2, product 3, and it has also sent the currency parameter as PKR. We can verify this information all over Google Analytics account. Since we have added this event parameter using a debug window, we can go to the debug view under the admin section of the Google Analytics 4, where we can see this event coming in. We can see that this already has an event items array. However, a second place where you can verify the same information is inside the reports for real-time views. If you go to the reporting section and click on real-time views, you will see that there are a different section where you can see the event coming in by the event name. And we do have a new event called view item list. The only backdrop of this section is that you won't be able to see any kind of items array here, but you can verify other information such as item list name and currency parameters. Everything sounds good. So let's just go back to the Google Tag Manager and publish the Google Tag Manager container. So let's do edit GA4 view item list events. Perfect. Let's just publish. So now the changes are live, and whenever a user is going to visit any of the collection pages on our Shopify store, we will track that event inside GA4. And this variable will be available for you in custom reports and in Google Data Studio, or renamed as Google Looker Studio, after 24 to 48 hours of the processing.